time now for the Shockley Honda Pet of the Week here on Free Talk 930 WFMD, 301-694-9363, 301-694-WFMD. And from the Animal Control Center, we've got Dee Dee in the studios. Good morning, Dee Dee. How are you?
Good morning. I'm good. How about you?
Fine, thank you. All right, so let's talk about what we brought this morning for us.
Well, what I brought you this morning is completely not a cat.
Not a cat.
She is a bunny. And she was adopted by someone a year ago and then given to some friends a month ago. And those friends acknowledged to us they didn't do any research. They didn't know anything about rabbits and brought her home and said, whoa, you know.
A month ago.
Yes.
Easter time?
Yes.
Okay.
So what would people need to know about rabbits is that they're agile and territorial and outgoing, and people think of rabbits as very passive and quiet, and that they're going to be some kind of simplistic pet. And they're no harder than a dog or cat. They're just different. They eat hay, and that's probably the most important thing you can know. The people who brought her to us didn't know that. They did buy her the rabbit food in a box, which has got some compressed hay in it. But really, rabbits have to eat fresh grass hay. Yes. So she's doing great. And she's a very, very friendly, outgoing, confident little rabbit. She's not overactive. She doesn't mind being handled and lifted. And that's a great thing, because when you get a rabbit secondhand, if they're fearful, which is their nature, it takes a long time to get them to trust you. And she's already trusting people in general.
So we have this wonderful opportunity for you to pick up this wonderful rabbit. If you like rabbit, do we know what kind of rabbit she is?
Or she's just part lion head. So she's miniature in size, and she has kind of longish hair that needs to be brushed a little. And she lets you do
it. You got to brush a rabbit?
Yeah. We created them to have this long abnormal hair because it's pretty. But then they need help taking care of it.
Okay.
And she's a beautiful golden color. Obviously, you can't see that on the radio, but she's very pretty and sweet, and I think she's going to make someone a nice pet. Just if you're interested in a more unusual pet, talk to us or talk to your 4-H friends. Make sure you know what you're in for. We have a list of small animal vets we can give you. You can even stop by Promised Land Feed. If you adopt her, they'll give you food for a week. Mm-hmm. But even if you don't, you can just stop by there and say, what would I need to know to have a rabbit as a pet?
And you can walk a rabbit.
Yes.
Put them on a leash.
Yep, little harness that attaches with Velcro. I had one when I was in college because, of course, the pet person that I am, the dorm that I moved to, said no dogs or cats. And I said, fine then.
I'll have a rabbit or a parakeet.
It was great. Yeah. Oh, and I should tell you, that rabbit lived 13 years. rabbits live a long time. So you have to be ready for that, too.
You have to be ready for that. So if you'd like to have the Shockley Honda Pet of the Week, do we have a name for this rabbit?
Her name is Nala.
Nala.
Yes.
Of course. She's a lionhead,
yes.
Right? So we might as well name her Nala. So, of course, you can pick her up. You can go see her. What's the rate for a rabbit?
It is a $50 adoption fee, which includes spaying. So that is a deal.
Yes, because only two. We can only have no more.
Yes.
No, we don't need more rabbits. You know what I mean? We don't need any more rabbits. We all know what they do.
We certainly don't need
any
more.
There you go. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Stop by the 1832 Rosemont Avenue. You can find them online, too. You can go to petfinder.com. It's the Morning News Express, 847 at Free Talk 930 WFMD.